Welcome to this presentation on Accessible Math on the Web, Part 2, The Simple Way with MathML and HTML5. My name is Greg Krause, University IT Accessibility Coordinator at NC State University. So what is MathML? MathML is an XML language used to describe math. It's a recommendation of the W3C for how to put math on the web. MathML consists of a set of elements that describes how all of the numbers or the variables and all the math operators, how they relate to each other, and how they should be laid out on the screen. The nice thing about MathML and HTML5 is HTML5 understands MathML natively. MathML is part of what we call HTML5's namespace. And because MathML is part of HTML5's namespace, you can literally just drop this MathML code into an HTML5 document, and if the browser supports it, it will actually display the equation as in a graphical representation. Now, I do need to note that if you want to include MathML in an HTML4 document or an XHTML document, there are some extra steps that you need to do, and that's because HTML4 and XHTML, those languages don't understand the MathML language natively. You have to add the MathML namespace to that, and we'll cover more of that in the next tutorial in this series. So this is what MathML looks like. And if you look at this and you're just confused and baffled because you don't understand it, don't worry. There are editors out there that create this for you. You're not expected to learn how to code MathML by hand. You usually use one of the editors to do this. MathType is one of the very popular editors to create MathML. So like I said, HTML5 understands MathML natively, so you can just take that code and drop it straight into a web page and the browsers will render it correctly. And so here's some examples of what it looks like in different browsers in Firefox, Opera, and Safari. Now, HTML5 is a newer standard, and the level of support for HTML5 in browsers does vary, so there are some browsers that don't yet support MathML and know what to do with it. So here's actually what happens when you try to put that MathML code and view it in Internet Explorer or Chrome. You don't get the visual output from it. And just to show you, MathML works on the iOS as well. Now, because all browsers don't know how to handle MathML yet, we can still use a library like MathJax, and MathJax will render that MathML equation on any browser. So just like in the first tutorial, we saw how MathJax can take a TeX or LaTeX equation and render it as a graphical representation. It can do the exact same thing with MathML. So even though there are some browsers that support it natively, if you do use MathJax to display your MathML, your equations will look the same no matter what browser the user has. The other advantage to using MathJax is it does allow assistive technology users to interact with the equations with a program called MathPlayer that works in Internet Explorer. As of right now, just sticking the MathML in a web page without MathJax will not give the assistive technology users the level of support they need. So let's see how to put all this together in a web page. So the first thing I'm going to do is come to MathType to create my equation. Now I'm going to keep this pretty simple. I'm going to use one of the pre-built equations to just insert it here. Now in my preferences menu, I'll come to the cut and copy preferences, and I'll choose the MathML or TeX format, and in the drop-down menu, I'm going to choose MathML 2.0 no namespace. And the reason I'm choosing that is because with HTML5, MathML is already part of the namespace, so I don't need to add any extra namespace attributes. Click OK. Then I'm just going to select all, choose a copy, and then I'll go paste this in my web page editor. So here I have my web page editor. In this case, I'm using Dreamweaver, but any web page editor will work. And I've got my MathML code, and I'm just going to stick that in between the body tags. So insert it like that. And even before I add in the calls to the MathJax libraries, if I save this document now, this will work in Firefox and in Opera and in Safari. So let's see what that looks like. So here's how that page looks in Firefox, just by sticking the raw MathML in my page without ever even needing to call MathJax. But like I said, if I just do it this way, if I view the same formula in Safari or Opera, the equation is going to look slightly different. Plus, my assistive technology users will not be able to interact with this in the ways that they need to. So now I'll just go back to Dreamweaver, and in the head section, I'm just going to add in the call to the MathJax libraries. So I'll save that, and let's go see what this looks like on the web page now. So let me just reload this page. And we'll see now it quickly loaded the MathJax libraries, and it's now using MathJax to render this equation. And it'll look exactly this way in whatever browser my user happens to be using. For more resources on accessible math, or to view the code from any of these examples, just go to the URL go.ncsu.edu/accessible-math.